Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Call of Duty Championship Australia Qualifier number 2. I'm in Maniac, joined by Naked. We are picking up a round 3 matchup of Planetronics NV up against Lollipop, which we saw a little earlier on stream. Now, we're actually seeing Lollipop, to most people's surprise, up 1-0. They took out that first hardpoint game. Now, we're going into S&D on Biolab. Naked, did you expect Lollipop to take out their first game?
We did see them have a pretty dominant performance this morning. We thought maybe they could cause an upset. And we're seeing it here. Obviously, Envy would easily be the favourite team. I'd say 90% of people would go with Envy. But at the same time, it's anyone's game. We saw them dominate the team they versed earlier. So I'm really looking forward to a close game here, hopefully.
I'm hoping we can see that as well. I just want to check out where all these players are located. We'll chuck on that COD vision. We've got Adidas Goondy chucking down the plant here on the A-bomb. We just saw Hunter being taken down in back. Goondy picking up the big kill there on Wanted. While dropping the plant, so we've got a 2v3 situation, and we're seeing this squad here of Lollipop looking good, especially when Fergs is now the only one left alive for the Envy squad. So yeah, Fergs, we got an uphill battle, and in fact, he is going to be taken down there.
I was very Lollipop.
I could tell.
I looked at my face and I was like, where am I?
I think you were lost. You were in, like, you had tunnel vision for this squad, and we're going to be seeing
Lollipop. I was really into the game, and so it's obviously, it's a pivotal game.
Look, no, I can appreciate that you were really into the game.
So that's what happens from many years of playing. You focus on the screen. I was just like, wait, I'm not playing. I'm here casting.
Yeah, you got lost for a minute. I lost you for a moment, but I'm glad you're back.
It's my old man. It's my old madness. Yeah, I'm back.
You sure?
Yeah,
do you need a moment?
I don't need mouth-to-mouth. Definitely not.
You good? Oh, okay. That's disappointing. Moving on, we're into the red building here with Wanted. Fergs for the Envy squad is just going to be chilling back. We do see it's Vozzy over on the far side here being dropped there after just taking the kill on Wanted. Woods was the one to finish him up. We're over here with Hunter. He's pulling back here. He's got the scope in hand, looking straight into purple where that B plant is. It looks like we're going to be seeing a little bit of action here. We've got Goody over here in the 5 building. There is a player just outside around the corner here. That's going to be Puzz. Excuse me, moving in, and he's going to spot Goondy there. He needs to watch himself as Goondy moves back into 5.
I'm not sure why he didn't shoot the canister there. It was right there for him to kill, and I just think he just was a bit scared, and that pretty much comes down to not being confident, I think. I think they're a bit worried. Lost the first map, lost the first round, and they're not playing their own gameplay, and that's going to really hurt them if they get that mindset early.
I totally agree. I think he just wasn't thinking straight here. There's a lot of pressure, just like as we saw in the last series where Citadel were unfortunately taken out. We're now seeing these guys, they both have to fight for their survival here in this championship.
Yeah, I'm thinking Envy, if they don't win here, they're going to be very, very disappointed. That's a big letdown for a big team name as well, and a lot of great players. Obviously, Ferg's been a champ before. I've teamed with 3 out of 4 of these players, so I know how well they can play. So it's just about them showing up today, and obviously they're picking up that round there, but they need to sort of turn it on now, and they can't play from behind. As we've stated so many times, once you get behind, it's so easy to just fall in that rat and just like sort of drag down while the other team just starts building momentum, and it just gets worse and worse for you.
This was a bit of a sloppy play here by Hunter in the end there, as Fergs was able to clean it up. There was also a player who was just on the green roof there. Too easy for them to clean it up. I suppose he was stuck between a rock and a hard place there, and unfortunately that's what's going to happen as Envy finally get a point on the board. We're now seeing the round score, 1 round apiece, and we're going to be seeing yet again this squad here of Lollipop on the attack.
Do you want to know something I find really, really weird? You know those canisters that blow up?
Yes.
It reminds me of Monsters, Inc., you know, the little scream canisters?
Yes.
And I'd love to see them just explode and get...
That really would be a great addition to a game.
It would be like I'd pay for that DLC.
Monsters Inc. DLC, I think I'd pay for that as well, quite happily. And then you can go in with like,
back to the game.
I was thinking we just need to dip this in the bud, otherwise it's Monsters Inc., man. We can go all day. Over with Goondy here. Macca's is being dropped. You can hear that chopper in the background. Macca's delivered by a chopper, which sounds about right. It's the future, man. We're over with Light here. He's chilling in Biolab now. lot, not much action happening here, to be honest. We're looking at Woodsy here. He's just outside of the B plan here, the purple. He's just going to be looking to see if anyone's going to make a move. That's Hunter, who's on the other side here. Woodsy lets his presence known by just going for a run by with the shots through the window. He's going to be moving back out towards the blue side here, peeping back through the side here. Spots one player caught off guard. That's Goondy, but not able to finish off the kill. Now, Vozzy also pushing through. This Hunter getting the kill on Puzz in the background. Is he going to get any kills here? I think he got one kill. He
finally took down Hunter.
That's right. It seems about the right ratio here. He finally gets another one. So that's two by taking down Vozzy as well. Now it's going to be all up to Light.
That was a double kill right then. I don't know if you noticed that. Those two people he killed right at the end. It didn't look like it.
That timing. I thought Light wasn't going to get that. And as you just saw there, he was finally taken out, which leaves enough time for Fergie to defuse. But Light just kind of stared at the player on the bomb there. It was quite interesting.
I really didn't like that play from Lollipops.
Oh, yep.
Together. They left 30 seconds to get on the bomb. Woods obviously was sitting there shooting. I think Goondy popped off the bomb for a second, then popped back on. So it took him so long to plant that 5-second plant. And then they already knew which bomb site they're at. They didn't have enough time to rotate. Envy can pretty much just converge and put him in that hole. And that's...
They gave the round away.
Yeah, pretty much, in my opinion, you never want to be at a bomb site with less than 30 seconds to go. And if you're defusing, you don't want to be there with less than 20 to go, because you're giving so much time to the other player to sort of toy with you. You want to be the one in control all the time, and a really rookie error is leaving that time, or at least leaving no time for you to rotate if the other bomb is not a no-go.
I totally agree with you there. Goondy now here is down in number 5. Let's go see what's happening here. We've got all players from Envy making a big push over here towards the A plant. We've got some scopes coming out by Puzzy. Just picked up Vozzy, and there is a player on the far side. That was Hunter. Just missed that one, though. He's going to be jumping back up onto the green roof as we're going to be seeing a play with the bomb here, crawling up towards this A plant. It looks like it's going to go down. Let's see who this is poking out of 5. That's Goonie with the nade out. It might be a good nade here. He missed any tags there. Tries to follow up with the second one. Did get the tags, but the bomb does go down on A and just misses the players there. We're going to see all players still up. Vozzy, the only one who's taken down now, and that's off the Lollipop Brigade. Let's see if he spots a player around the side, but no, Woods is going to be a bit too quick, taking down Light, and Hunter is going to be returning fire by taking down Puzz, but then just like that, he's going to be cleaned up to make the score 3 points
to 1. Starting to pick it up really well here, and that's what you expect from players of that caliber. You expect them to start picking up these rounds, but...
Well,
Goondy
considering
Co, yeah, they're doing really well.
Considering Lollipop took out the first map, which unfortunately we didn't see on screen, but Lollipop to take the hard point away from Envy is worth surprising to me.
Another interesting thing I seen Goondy actually tweeted that they won on Envy's host. So Envy obviously picked to host the hard point, and we've been seeing most of the teams that have been hosting first winning their hard point. That's the advantage you pick by doing that. They lost that. Now they're going into giving the other team 3 chances to host, especially online. Is one of them being S&D, fair enough, but it's going to make it hard for themselves. It's a must-win map when you choose to host first.
You've said it spot on. It really is a must-win map, but look, we're seeing these guys, Lollipop, have it in them to win this S&D, and it just looks like they aren't quite as composed as Envy are on this map and game type. Now, we just see this bomb has been planted here by Adidas Goondy. He gets it down quite easily, considering that 2 members of Lollipop already taken down. Make that 3 as Woods gets added to that list. It's all up to Puzz now to stay alive. The bomb has been planted over at A. 30 seconds left to make a move and take down these players. It's not going to happen. And now we're seeing the score 2-3 as we see the Lollipop Brigade come back a little bit.
Definitely a close and very interesting game. As we pretty much have said 100 times, Envy lose this game, it's going to go to another respawn game type. They didn't win the first one. We don't know how much. We don't know if they were smashed or if it was close. I would have loved to have found out the score. They need to win this, really. We don't want to be down 2-0. I don't think a team has recovered from a 2-0 besides Trident this whole weekend. And Trident, obviously, such a great team. They qualified first. So you're going to really need some great composure if you're down 2-0, especially when you're not a proper team. It's hard to have that kind of chemistry without kind of arguing in that.
Trident broke the rules of nature, and we're obviously our first team to go through to our Asia Pacific qualifiers. So, yeah, look, if any team wants to come close to that, they definitely must be aiming high. Woods just took down Vozzy. He's got the scope out again on this green building that he loves so much. He's just checking out. There's a player over there on the green cap. And that's going to be Fergs over here with the bomb. Full red, a lot of color at the moment. And he needs to watch these guys that are around. There's a couple of players around this five building. We need to see who's over here. That's going to be Hunter up top as he got the kill there onwards. He's playing with the Riot Shield as well. There's been a lot of talk about that Riot Shield over the Twitter sphere as well. But look, Hunter knows how to capitalize it.
He's done really well with it. We've seen it in their uplink here. They had a great presence of mind to bring out their Riot Shield and boost over while they were shooting off Respawn. And he just capped it, no problem. So I really like it. I like the versatility of him to know when to use it, and he uses it really well. It's not like he just uses it and just sits there. He knows exactly when to use it, and that's a great asset to have in your team, to have someone that does something different, and people aren't used to it.
As you can see, they're a bit thrown off by the Riot Shield.
And obviously, it angers them too, and if you can get someone off their game, that's another one-up for your team.
Mate, if you can get someone on tilt, I guarantee you it throws off their game 100%. Goondy there got lucky spotting the player through the ice up in Biolab to tie things up. Now three rounds apiece. I honestly didn't expect Envy to drop, well, either
after
of those last two.
Lead, yeah.
Exactly. We're just consistently eating our words here as these teams keep fighting back. We're going to be seeing the guys from Lollipop fight back here. Goondy with the bomb in hand. He's got even money for his KD. Three plants to his name, though, which is quite impressive that he's maintained at least an even KD while getting those plants down for his team. Playing the OBJ. Nice work by him. There is a player just around the corner there. He's already made it there, and he was caught off guard. That was Wanted. Excellent positioning by Wanted there.
Yeah, he's done really, really well to get there and then get away without dying, and then eventually died in the end. But he did really good to not die and obviously let them trade.
Yeah. Well, he killed the person who was important anyway. We've now got Hunter with the bomb in hand, putting that down at A. Woods and Puzz, the only players left alive. I tried to jump over to Woods just as Light took him out. Now we've got Puzz, the only man left alive. He starts getting starts going to work. He took down one. There was a player who just jumped up high above the A plant. He ended up going up to Cat, and it was just unfortunate that he didn't see that. So our score now sitting at 4-3, and we're seeing Lollipop now back in the lead.
The warning signs would be going off in that Envy camp there. It's not looking good. They had a really good lead. They had a chance to finally equal up the maps, and they've just let three rounds like that slide. And if they lose another one, I don't like to think that they're going to win the next map if they don't win this map.
I'm a bit scared for them. They've been pretty decent on their attack, though, and they are yet again on the attack, as you can see here. Fergs starting things off by running through to A, as we always see. I just want to see how...
With the defense.
Yeah, exactly. I want to see how these guys play the defense here. Fozzie getting shut down really quick, though. And we're just seeing Goony now going
like
to
that.
Work as well in the background, but not as much as Hunter, who just took down Puzz. And now Fergs, the only man left alive, and he's made a big rotation up here in the B. He's in the purple area. Now it's up to the two players, Hunter and Goony, to go get the defuse here. Let's see how Fergs plays this out, considering he's the only man left alive. His team are currently behind by the 1 point. He starts by taking down Hunter. That's the beginning, folks. One more kill here, and there is a player just outside. He needs to watch himself. I think they might be up on the Cat. It's Goony. Let's see where he is. He was just poking in. They're going to run into each other. No, they're not. Goony needs to watch his flank. Fergs, he's just playing it nice and passive here. But Goony, as we know, needs to make a move. Let's see how Fergs responds to this. He posts out the window. Excellent work. That was well played by Fergs.
That round was great. Goony and co, four-man defense. And it was great. They won the trade-off. They ended up 2-1 left. Fergs, even better play, went by himself to the other bomb site, knew that there were so many people there, and he was the furthest back at the time. When he seen his team start dying, he rotated, planted the bomb. If he didn't plant it that quickly, he would have been in trouble. So then moving through quickly into their spawn before they could even react, picking up the kill on H22K, and then moving up to Goondy. Goondy hears him break the glass with the grenade and didn't actually react to him being in the building. He sort of made a mistake there and didn't obviously think that the glass had to have broken. He would have had to have been in the building, could have been outside of it, and pretty much Fergs got kind of lucky, but also did really well to get in that position for his team. And that might be the round that they need to push him back and take this map.
It was really a brilliant play by Fergs, and I really think it was that point that have kept Envy in this game, at least kept their competitive spirit alive. Look at Light, he's going to be able, he didn't put any shots out there, but he's going to be able to communicate that information to his team that these players have come through red. However, look at the flank behind him, he gets taken out. Woods is pushed straight into Biolab as well, and you see those red arrows converging onto purple here. Fergs getting a kill as well. Hunter, the only one left alive, and he's out here on the green Cat. Look, he just saw Fergs, or at least he should have. He does now as he gets the shots out. sloppy shots, tries to finish off the kill eventually, but he's going to be shut down. That was not a brilliant play there for his team.
That was another good play, though, from Envy. They sent three on the flank. Light actually seen all of them come, but the problem was the person in middle in Biolab didn't react, obviously, quick enough to Woods picking up the initial kill, which put pressure on Light, who had to push out and lost his 1v1 gunfight. So eventually losing those kills has made two sort of miscommunications, you might say. Maybe Light didn't call out the flankers. Might have just cost them the two rounds, and they could have almost sealed Envy away.
Yeah, I really think Light should have capitalized more on that information. There's no way that flank from Envy should have happened, but that it did? Envy just, they punished them for it, smashed them for it, and capitalized very, very well, all converging on that purple building in the end, and it just became too easy for them. Now they're only one round away from their first map victory. We could still see some overtime here. It's still yet to be determined. Let's have a look. There's a bit of fire going out. Vozzy gets the first kill on Woods. He's got this thermal out. Let's see if he can pick up another one. Fergs still with the bomb in hand. He wants to make a push towards B. There's a couple of players checking it out. Over here, you're going to have Hunter, who's right on the steps, just behind him now, rotating back towards the 5 building, hiding in the corner. It's going to be Light, but I think Hunter might be running into someone pretty soon. We've got the bomb carrier trying to make this push into purple. It's only Fergs and Wanted left alive. Let's see what's going to happen. Hunter might have to poke forward here and have a look. He's just biding his time, though, with 32 seconds left before they have to make a move. It's still plenty of time, obviously, and the bomb carrier is just to his left. I'm not sure if he's going to notice it, as the other members of his team are just fapping about over in blue and outside of 5. So it's going to be up to Hunter, and look at that, the bomb perfectly placed by Wanted. Now you're going to be seeing everyone making a mad dash. Fergs does get the plant before he goes down. Now it's Wanted, the man left, to keep it all alive, and it's not going to happen. So you're going to be seeing these guys get the defuse, and it's going to be things tied up, 5 rounds apiece. We're going to overtime, Naked.
Yeah, well, that was really, really good play from Most Wanted, obviously, to get that first initial kill. Ferg's very unlucky. He must have just been an angle of his legs just sitting out to be shot, and then Wanted not picking up the kill. That's another bit unlucky, but we're going to a 6-5 situation going to happen to one team. Who are you picking, Josh?
I don't dare guess.
You've got to pick one.
All right. If I have to pick one, I'm going to say Envy.
Okay, I'm going to say Envy as well.
I'm going to say Envy because they're on the attack. Their
just
attacks
so
have been
we're
pretty
always
good.
Wrong, that's why.
Because I see what you did there. So it was four plants have been given to Fergs so far. He's going to be trying to go for another one here to win this map for his team. And really, he has to, given that Lollipop won the first one.
Yeah, they really do need to win this. Fergs, interestingly enough, has 4 plants, so I'm pretty sure only one round they haven't been able to plant the bomb. So if he can do that, they're a good chance in winning this round. They need to get the opening kill. They've been suffering from dying from sniping and nades off the first kill, and they need to get this opener. They look a bit worried. They're obviously all rotating, and I think they've done a good enough job. No one is at A, I think, or one is in the middle building. No one's at A. They can capitalize here if they're quick enough.
I'm surprised this far into a round that everyone's still alive, to be honest. We're seeing the big rotate. There's one player
scared,
here
what it is.
With the thermal. He's inside of 5, so the first one to get shots off is actually going to be Goondy. He knows the players are going for that B plant, so he's trying to get those long-range bombs out. There is going to be someone up close. That's going to be Vozzy. We'll jump over to him. One player first did get taken down. Look at that. That explosive coming into play as he was taken down by Wanted. Hunter gets the kill on Wanted in return. So now we're seeing a 3v2 situation. 3v1 now, as Puzz is going to be the only one left alive for Envy, and it looks like it's going to actually be a Lollipop round. But with that said, 2v1 situation, and look at that, Puzz.
He jumped up. That cost him the kill then. Wow. Big round there, 2-0 lead for Lollipop. Sorry, I was about to say Candy Canes.
That was a huge slip up by Puzz.
That's unlucky. That actually used to happen a lot on Ghost. He'd accidentally jump up, and obviously meant to boost up to keep shooting, and instead, yep, grabbed up on the wall, and that's so unfortunate.
That was really, really unfortunate.
He did well to get out of that situation.
No, it wasn't completely his fault. I mean, it was just a mechanic of the game that came into play there. With that said, I mean, it could be argued that he should have known a little bit what he was doing. But look, round 11, under that kind of pressure, your team's already a map down.
He was in a 1v3. He did well to get the first kill, and he did well to get away. He actually juked the first guy. They had him pretty much trapped in. He managed to get out, so he did well then. Unfortunate enough, that is the darkest character I've ever seen, that character there.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, so quite interestingly, we're going to be seeing Lollipop go ahead in that series 2-0. So it has to it has to go through to this game number three, and they have to stay alive. What we're going to be doing before we go into game number three, which is capture the flag on Ascend, we're going to go to a quick break, and we'll come back with Lollipop versus Envy.